Here's your bowl.
Oh.
Here's a good boy. Thank you. Yeah. Do you want it?
Nice.
Can you catch it? Woohoo!
Oh.
You should be in a circus.
Doctor, can you fix these two teeth in the front? I'm sitting in one of the most picturesque settings that I've been to in California, and this is the home of one of the hottest singers in the whole world in the Santa Monica Mountains of Malibu, about how many miles? 15 miles from Hollywood? And you'll be able to see her own ABC TV special November 17th, and this is her new album I'm showing you right now. It's called Don't Stop Believing. Here is Olivia Newton-John.
Hi.
Hi. How long have you lived here?
I lived here about 9 months. In America or
no,
right here?
No, in Hollywood. Hi.
In Hollywood, nearly 2 years now.
this is my first meeting with this one. Is he friendly?
Summer. Yes, they're all friendly.
Oh, they're marvelous.
Come say hello.
Oh, they're just
He's
marvelous.
Only 9 months old, can you believe that?
9 months. Think of when he grows up. How old is Zygon?
He's four.
Four.
Zygon's four. Domino's
Zygon.
A puppy, you can tell.
Yeah.
Careful.
Are you going to end up in the movies, I hope?
Well, if they ask me.
They've asked. They had to have asked. I keep reading that you're...
I'm going to
test for this
too.
And going to test for that. In fact, Burt Reynolds said he was thinking of you for a part in something.
Yes, I've had a lot of scripts, but I haven't yet read anything that I've felt would be right for me. I guess when I read it, it'll happen. It's like hearing a song.
Kind of thing. You have in mind what you're looking for in the way of a script?
Not
what
really.
What you'd like to play?
No, I think when I read
it...
It
just has to strike you.
Yeah. Yeah.
You're from England originally, but you went to Australia to live for a number of years in your early childhood. Is the lifestyle much different there than it is here?
In England?
Yeah.
Well, the weather, of course, makes a lot of difference because you don't have a summer as such, apart from the drought they're having now, which is very unusual.
Terrible.
It's boiling
all
hot.
Over Europe,
yeah.
Yes.
But, no. And, of course, I didn't have the same success in England, so my lifestyle wasn't quite as good. But it's a wonderful place to live, but it's very, very opposite to America. Yeah.
I assume when I see someone as young and as attractive as you who lives in an area like this with the animals and you've got horses and everything, that you're kind of a loner. You don't like really the party life and the opening. This one's opening and that one's opening.
I like it now and then when I choose it, but I really love being in the country. And this is as close to the country as I can be without being too far from town.
Yeah.
And I've always had a passion for animals, but when I was younger, I was never allowed to have any. Whoops.
Oh, gee, terrific.
Oh, Jackson, look at you.
No, that's terrific. I'll remember you for that. No, that's okay. I don't mind that. What I mean is that when you're normally in this business, you know, you have press agents and people of that nature calling you and saying, so-and-so's opening at such and such a place. I think you should be there and be seen. You don't really go for that sort of thing.
I don't go to many things. Sometimes I do because I like to meet the people too. I'm still a bit starstruck and I get a kick out of meeting some of the, you know, famous people.
Oh, that's wonderful to hear.
So,
when were you last really thrilled to meet someone? Because you said you were starstruck.
It was nice to meet you today. hold on, let me think.
You're very
kind. I meet people all the time. I think it was a great thrill. I met Paul Newman once in a plane. And
what did you say to him? Remember what you said to him?
I don't know. I think I stumbled over my tongue.
That's right. When you see those people, you know, you've seen them all your life, and suddenly there they are in front of you. You want to get it all out in one statement and make it very eloquent and lovely.
Yeah,
and
never do. I always get it every time.
You have a lot of security here.
Yeah.
You have four dogs?
Yes, I have four dogs and a cat and six horses.
A cat and six horses?
Yep.
Oh, that's marvelous. You like living in a big house like this?
Yeah, I do. I mean, the house itself isn't that huge, but the land is lovely. It gives you a great feeling of
How much land
openness.
Have you?
Nearly 4 acres.
That is nice. Mm-hmm. You're single. With your hectic schedule.
He wants you
I'm
to throw the ball.
I'm not talking to you, Jack. Oh, where is the ball?
Where'd you put it?
I'll get it.
This
He's now
demanding.
That Jackson, this is it between you and me. After this, it's over, okay? Wait, I better not throw it toward the camera. There you go, fella.
Oh, brilliant.
Oh, he's terrific. I was going to say, you're single and you've got a hectic schedule.
Yeah.
Do you have much time for social life?
Not all that much, but I really, it hasn't been too bad this year. Last year, I didn't have a chance to do anything much at all. This year, I've had an opportunity to go out a fair bit. But what I like doing most of all is having people here because
like
I have everything here and I love to be able to.
You know what I remember most about you? That you're very, you like to do things yourself. You don't like a lot of people doing things for you. One time when you were on my show, somebody came up and said, she's ironing her own dress. You were ironing your own dress, and that was, they were stunned to see the star doing that. You remember that?
Yes, I do, actually.
Yeah, you still do all those things?
Not as much as I used to. I'm getting lazy now. I like to do some things by myself. But
you like to cook?
I like to keep independence. Yes, I do.
Are you a good cook?
Not too bad. I'm out of practice, because I'm away so much. When I get back, I always get everything wrong. Burn it or something.
Are you involved with anyone special now? Is there a special man in your life?
Yes.
The fellow I read about, Lee Kramer, is
yes,
that his name?
Right.
Yeah. Would you like to get married?
I'm not sure. Sometimes I think I would, and sometimes I don't think I would.
Yeah. In one of the articles I read, because they, you know, they give you lots of homework when you're going to talk to somebody like you, it said, I'm not thinking about marriage right now. I'm not ready for kids. How does a girl know when that time comes, when she's ready for kids, especially someone as busy as you?
Well, I guess when I feel, I mean, my career is very demanding, and I believe that if you're going to have a family, you should devote as much of your time to them, because the first couple of years of their life are very important. And if you were preoccupied or too busy, I don't think that's right for children. So I guess within the next few years, I'll decide whether I want to slow down a bit. And if I do and when I do, then that's the time for children.
Do you want a large family?
Oh, yeah. I've never really gone into it. No, I think if I had children, I'd want two so that they'd have a companion.
Yeah, that is nice. We'll be right back. Oh. You know what fascinates me? You're known as a country singer. I keep seeing your name on country music charts. I see that you win awards at country shows. And yet, is that really your type of music? Because I've never thought of it as being country.
Country is sort of an integral part of what I do, but I never have classed myself as a country singer. When anyone asks me, I'd say, I'm a singer and I sing country, but I love to sing pop and I love to sing old songs and new songs, anything really. But I suppose to have a label of any sort is good. At least, you know, I had success with country music, so I'm very thrilled to have it. But I do actually do other things as well.
Have you been accepted by Nashville yet?
I think just about. Yes, I have. No, I'm kidding.
Also, read where you said something in terms of your music that you like happy music, that you like conveying that to other people. There's enough sadness in the world that you like conveying happiness through your music. Is that still true?
I do like to do that as well, but I generally like to sing love songs because that's something that's close to everyone. And they're not always happy, as you know. But songs, I was once accused of being my songs were too much in a dream world and life wasn't really like that, but I feel sometimes it's nice to forget realities and, you know, nice.
You know, when I saw you, when I first saw you today and I approached you, I couldn't take my eyes off of that key. And you assumed that we all knew about a key like that. You said you got it on your 21st birthday. Tell our viewers what that's about, because it is not common to this country.
It's not, no. This is a traditional thing, I think, in Australia too. When you turn 21, you get the key to the door. Well, that's the idea. And I think the idea was from the olden times that children never had the front door key or latch key until they were 21. So the tradition carried on, and when I was 21, I got a lot of keys, sort of frame keys and cards made of keys, but this was given to me, and I've worn it ever since.
That's
it's actually
marvelous.
A key ring.
Oh, that's really
See?
Cute, yeah.
That's lovely, isn't
Who gave it?
It
to you, your parents?
No, just a friend of mine.
How does your family feel? I read that your grandfather, I didn't know that your grandfather was a famous physicist who won the Nobel Peace Prize and all.
Mm-hmm.
How does your family feel about this success? Because you didn't finish school, as I recall. You told me you didn't finish school. How do they feel about that?
At first, that didn't go down very well. Because my sister had left school to become an actress, and they hoped that
At
I would...
At 15,
Yeah,
right?
she's 15. So they hoped that I would go to university and everything, because my father was a professor, and my mother comes from a very academic family, and my brother is a doctor, so it was sort of presumed that I would go into something like that.
Is he a specialist or just a general
He's a specialist in infectious diseases. She's very handy.
Yes, handy right now. We should have had him in Philadelphia not long ago. Has all this success affected your life?
Well, I suppose it has to.
How? How has it affected your life?
It's very hard to say. My life is... I've had success in sort of slow stages. It isn't something that suddenly hit me.
You think of that as being slow stages? What?
10 years or something. 12 years, actually.
12 years? We think of you as like, pow, there's Olivia with a hit record.
It just,
isn't that funny? You've been at it that long?
I started when I was 15. So I did leave school when I was 15. And... I'm now 28, so it's nearly 13 years. It has to affect it, of course, because your lifestyle changes, and therefore the things that you do and the places you go to change a little bit. I have tried to keep it pretty much as it was, but I've changed country, so therefore my friends have changed also, because I had to leave them behind. And it's very hard to
go ahead.
Put a finger on what has actually changed. I've tried to keep my values as much as possible.
Oh,
I think that's
so important.
Very important.
Did you really keep your flat in London, everything with the furniture all covered up, as I read in an article?
I kept it for a while until they told me that I wasn't allowed to own anything and I had to sell it, which was sad.
That is sad.
Yeah.
Do you feel pressure now that you're on top to constantly stay on top?
Actually, no, for a while it used to worry me, and now I feel that, you know, I never dreamt in my life that I'd have a number one record, or that I'd have a gold record, or that I'd have a platinum record, or I'd play at Las Vegas, or... everything that I've done was sort of a wild dream that I never thought would come true, so therefore I've really achieved most of my goals, and therefore if it didn't happen, obviously things have to level out for a while.
Sure.
And I feel very thrilled that I've done what I have done, so I'm not panicked. I feel I've accomplished most of what I want to do, and now I want to just attain a high level of good music and try and improve.
You said gold records and platinum records. How many records all told? How many gold and how many platinum?
Oh, now you've got me.
Have I got
you?
I
haven't added them up. There's a few.
How many million records have you sold? Has anybody hit you with a figure?
No, I don't know if there's anyone.
You know
like
who to
that.
Turn to on something like that? We'll find out before this is over.
Back.
Don't worry. Everybody, when they become successful, I know I did it, I know I've talked to a lot of people who have, they splurge on something that they've never had before. And they go out and say, wow, I got this. I just got to buy such and such. What was the first thing you splurged on when you became successful?
Let me think about this. Oh, I know. I moved to America, and the first thing I bought was a Volkswagen convertible. That's as splurgy as I got. And then I started getting animals, because that was something I was never allowed to have when I was younger. And we didn't have the room for them. And I suppose clothes. Because to go into to shop and be able to have what you want to have without having to worry about it is a lovely feeling.
Yeah. You mentioned Vegas a moment ago. And even when you've attained success, that's a frightening thing to walk on that stage all by your lonesome, isn't it? Were you terribly nervous upon opening the first time?
Very, yeah.
What do you do to overcome nervousness when you get that way? Everybody has a different method. Take a lot of deep breaths or what?
I sing a lot.
Just keep singing?
In the dressing room for a long time and try and stop the shakes. there's really nothing much you can do except, you know, the first night is always the worst, and I always wish that people would come to the second or the third night.
Yeah.
You know? It would be easier, but I just concentrate and try and think of it as being a second night when I go out there. That never works.
Oh, that's interesting. But there's nothing. I mean, do you look for familiar faces when you're nervous like that?
No, that's the funny thing. I really don't like friends in the front row because somehow friends and family make me more nervous because they expect more of me. I don't know if you're the
same.
That's
right. Yes, sure. I'm glad to hear you say that because that's, I always, when I see even my wife out there, I give it I press just a little bit, try a little too hard. But you've recorded, you've done TV specials, you're obviously going to do movies because you've got that just a certain look that I think will be fantastic on the screen. Isn't that kind of a thought in the back of your head that you really want that?
I think it would be lovely, but I have done one bad film in my life and I vowed that I'd never do it.
You have? What was it?
It was called Tomorrow, and I was in a group at one stage and they made a film of us and it was going to be a big thing, you know, we were like the new monkeys of film.
Oh, yeah.
And it was not a good film, and I always said that if I ever did anything after that, even, I'd rather not do anything than do something that was not up to par. So we'll wait and see. It'll happen or it won't.
You're right. I understand you've just recorded a new single called Every Face Tells a Story.
Mm-hmm.
Is that correct? And we have the tape, which we're going to see right now.
Douglas reminding you to watch Olivia Newton-John's special, November 17th.
That song was from this album I'm showing you right now. Can you keep that right there? I'll show you the other side. It's really nice. Isn't that nice? So no matter which side is up, you're going to buy it. It's a winner. I read that you have no musical training. You sing by ear.
That's right.
Yeah.
It hurts.
And you said, I really don't know the key I'm in, but if the band's in the same key, everything's fine.
Actually, I said that in a joke, but it is basically true. No, I can read music very slowly, but I usually can pick up something if I've heard it once through. I get it the next time. So.
Yeah, how many chords do you know on a guitar?
About a dozen, I suppose. I can play something really
You could
basic.
Be in a rock band.
Yeah.
I'm fascinated with the barn, and I know you're into horses.
Mm-hmm.
Now, there was a horse that threw you.
Yes.
And that wasn't meant to be. He didn't mean it, did he?
No, it was really an accident. It was one of those things. I was riding in a very mountainous place up behind here, and the saddle was slipping, so I got off to tighten the girth, and as I was getting on, he was excited and he wouldn't stand still. So he kept turning in circles and things, and I got fed up in the end and just tried to hop on. And he took off at a gallop down the hill, so
Oops.
I went over his back and landed on my back. And it was just unfortunate.
Did you hurt yourself badly?
Fairly, yeah.
You rode him, you told me, today for the first time.
Yeah. It was.
How was he?
He was fine. He's not really a mean horse, but you get like a thing about riding them again after that, but I had to get over it.
Isn't one of the horses a racehorse?
Yes, one of them is a thoroughbred, yeah.
Do you race him?
No, I haven't. He was on the track until last year, and then he was taken off the track, and he was actually
Why?
Given to
Why
me.
Why was he taken off the track?
I don't think he was quite fast enough. That's what they told me. He did win once in Kentucky. I've got a picture of him winning something, so at least he's done something terrific.
Yeah. Where do you ride around here? It's so mountainous and hilly.
Some fantastic trails up behind here, you know, that are perfect for it. I like riding on flat land, but there isn't much around here.
I like riding on horses that maybe have an hour to live. That don't move too rapidly, you know, because I was thrown from a horse one time. It's the strangest feeling when you're in the air and you know there's nothing to grab a hold of.
Yeah.
You are coming down.
That's
I mean, your mind works so quickly. You say, I thought about a circus performer, how they relax. And I think that's why I didn't hurt myself.
You relaxed? In all that time you thought of that? That's
incredible. Because the horse, they made me sit on the rump of a horse to take a picture with a lady bareback rider for a circus thing I was supposed to. And the horse didn't want me back there and just went up in the air. I was like, I must have been 8 or 9 feet in the air when I thought of all this. And I looked down, there was asphalt like this below me.
Ooh. But it can be horrible.
Yeah. You say you have four horses?
But six down
Six?
There.
Mm-hmm. Do you ride Western or English?
I ride both, but Western on trail rides is much more comfortable.
Yeah,
I enjoy it. I must admit, that until I came to America, I always thought Western was, you know, it wasn't the done thing. I was very into the English saddle and all that sort of thing. But I've been to a lot of horse shows where they've done rodeos, and I'm really fascinated by it now. There's quite an art to it, really.
You good, horsewoman?
Not bad.
Not bad. Do you feel secure now that you've achieved this success?
In myself or in my work?
In yourself.
In myself. Yeah, pretty. I mean, I don't think anyone ever feels completely secure with themselves. I mean, that would be disastrous, and you get too content, and you wouldn't try and strive for anything else.
Mm-hmm.
But much more secure than I was, I guess.
No. How about on stage performing in one?
Oh, yes.
Much more secure.
Much more. You know, I think confidence helps. If you have a bit of success, that helps your confidence and that helps your performance, and it sort of, hopefully builds from that, you know. But I'm never completely confident on stage because I think that could be bad as well.
Oh, yeah. Too easy to thinking you're too good and it all falls apart. You've got a marvelous special coming on November 17th on ABC. And Olivia will not tell us one thing about it, because the whole thing is a surprise, right?
Mm-hmm.
You know what the biggest surprise is? When you get there, they're not going to have a special. No.
You're right.
But you don't know who any of the guests are or anything?
I do, but I'm not telling.
Oh, you can't? And when they advertise it, they're just going to say, watch Olivia Newton-John, November 17th on ABC. What time will it air?
I think it's 10 o'clock. 10 o'clock? Yeah.
10 o'clock Eastern, 9 in the Midwest.
It's just going to be a good night because there's three specials that night, Dorothy Hamill and then John Denver and then mine.
Oh,
so it should be
hello, I should say.
Quite exciting.
Olivia, thank you for letting us invade upon your privacy. I mean, you know, we have a few people up here right now. And I know you're not.
Thank you for coming. It's lovely to have you.
My pleasure. Wonderful seeing you again. Good luck on November 17th.
Thank you.
We'll be right back.